realized very quickly that I lacked political experience as I was getting through this process, and kind of the Chicago-style politics of it was pretty shocking. And what I realized was the system is there currently designed to protect the incumbent and make it hard for there to be substantive change, make it hard for someone who is a visionary on the outside to come in and break up a structure that stymies progress in this country. I do believe that I saw behind the curtain, and it worried me that there's a handful of people that are in control of the levers that not only control the election process, but also the macro idea of the game in this country. I mean, everything that trickles down to the lower parts of the pyramid, it's all a handful of people at the top that are triggering these decisions and these technical areas that the grassroots or the state associations have to react. So
whose interests are they representing?
Well, I mean, the massive interest is the professional league here. So Major League Soccer has an enormous amount of influence on the game in this country. Now, some of that influence is positive, but some of that influence, it makes it difficult for there to be a division between church and state, between U.S. soccer and between Major League Soccer, because it's not... Some things are not mutually beneficial, and what's hard is, in order to break that up, someone on the outside, quote unquote, has to win, has to come in and be willing to improve transparency and get rid of the Byzantine way that they govern, which makes it so difficult for someone to come from the outside out. I mean, if you really do the math on how this election played out, it really was about a dozen or so people that controlled more than half of the vote, and that's, forget the fact that there has been an open election, as you were saying, since soccer's been invented, but having that small group of people have that much influence is not democratic. And so in order for us to move forward as a soccer country, we have to give voices and weight to the people that are at the grassroots level that can help us understand where we're missing, where we're not growing the game. So I'm hopeful that Carlos Cordero can be the person to initiate the change that's necessary, because if we don't change the culture that didn't allow for a challenged election, didn't allow for anyone to come forward and challenge Sunil Gulati for three terms, if Carlos Cordero truly is the change candidate that he was selling on his platform, and listen, I'll be here for him in whatever way he needs in order to help grow the game and recognize the areas that U.S. soccer is missing, but he has the opportunity right now to be the one to push for that cultural change inside, so outside candidates every 4 years can come and challenge, and it can be a meritocracy.